Hello, lovelies. We are here for you today to review for you Rocket from the Marvel Universe. Let's start a fire.
This is the very first Marvel comic I have ever read.
Wait, you didn't read any of Jessica Jones?
No. I didn't read The Vision when you told me to read it.
You didn't read the...
I didn't read Jessica Jones. So, Rocket is my very first dive into the Marvel world. And that might shock everybody.
How do you feel about it?
I don't know if I'm going to stick around for any more Marvel comics.
Any more Marvel?
I don't know. Like, so, I feel like this was... Maybe this is definitely the wrong one for me to start on.
Yeah, I think so. I think you should have read The Vision.
I should have read The Vision.
I will give you Jessica Jones.
You have it?
I have The Pulse, which you won't like.
Okay.
And I have...
Why not?
Alias. You'll like Alias, probably.
Okay.
You're not gonna like The Pulse because it's got that Marvel charm.
You mean written for children and...
Kind of.
Corny? That's probably how I could describe this. What? Let me not say any more bad things.
It's charming.
Kitschy sounds too nice. Let's talk about who created this comic first.
Al Ewing and Adam Gorham.
And Adam Gorham?
Yes.
And Al Ewing is known for Ultimates and US Avengers, which, did you ever read those? Heard about them? I haven't. I actually was really interested in Al Ewing's writing style for this. I think the narration is what kept me interested in reading Rocket. So it's written in first person for sure, mm-hmm. right? And it's heavily narrated. So you have Rocket's inner thoughts on the side, or I guess you can say, and then what's happening.
Right.
Right.
Because essentially Rocket is telling a story. I think they have that scene, right? Where he's at the bar. And he's telling the story of Otto?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I like that because you do get like a fuller story, whereas traditionally you just get what's going on in that time. And he kind of reflects and talks about how he felt in the moment, and then you get to see it, which I really like. Enjoyed.
I think you guys should let us know, or let me know, how this plays out in terms of how many times Rocket has been rebranded and relaunched. And how this fits into that, into his universe. Because I think it was really... I read it because I liked Guardians of the Galaxy, the movie. So I was interested in learning more about his character. And I think maybe this Rocket, number one and two, kind of gave us a different insight into Rocket's life and how he became who he is.
Definitely. This is leading off until he meets Peter
Quill.
Okay. Because they kind of show it a little bit,
mm-hmm.
which I think is really cool because you never do get to know how he met Groot or how, like, what happened to get him into that prison in the first movie. So I would continue reading this. I wouldn't end here.
Yeah, this is definitely one of those stories that tells you why he became, or he was a bad guy, but then became a good guy, kind of.
He wasn't all that bad, though. He's not all that bad. He is like a little bit of a badass, though.
Morally ambiguous. Like, that's what Rocket is. Which kind of takes you into what his character is. Like, he's not a human being, so I'm gonna get all philosophical. So how does he know what is morally right or wrong?
That's
he's this
true.
Created creature.
He's not even an actual animal.
No. I don't know what he is. He's not a raccoon because he doesn't like being called that.
Right. He was made by scientists to be a pilot or to be a space thing.
This story, though, was really melodramatic. Like, I think it was like a bad I think it was like a really cheesy detective story.
It did like make me think about those like late 80s early 90s movies like Ferris Bueller, especially with the narration too, and how it's just kind of like, you know, it has that like attitude ego to it, like that little snarkiness.
Yeah.
So
so it felt like a bad movie.
No.
But one thing, whoa, rocket.
No. It was mad at her for calling it a bad movie. It has charm and kitsch, okay?
What I would say about, not number one, but number two, I really liked that it was, so it starts off with a future scene and sandwiches what happens to get Rocket to where he is, and then ends it with, does that make sense? That I'm totally not making sense. It's a sandwich.
They flipped it and reversed it.
So future, sandwiched in past, and then future. That's how I'm gonna describe it. That was number two. What are we talking about now?
How it looked.
Oh, it looked all right. No.
No, I liked it. Very interested. It had like nice neon colors, and like they had color washes over there. I don't know what they used to create them. It's definitely drawing and...
Yeah. It was just like a solid look. Rocket, it's himself, I think, if this is a great take on what he looks like. Because the other ones I feel like were too old school looking.
They made him look too cute.
Cute?
Yeah, they made him look too much like a raccoon.
I don't know, I feel like it was...
They always like make him so much smaller than Quill, and like Groot is obviously humongous, but...
Yeah. I would definitely say he's like a larger size raccoon. Like he's, or not a raccoon, but right. He's definitely big.
But I'm saying like comic wise. Not even talking about the movies, but he's probably like a small child, maybe like a 12-year-old.
Yeah, not like, look how tall he looks. Like
he's probably about, I don't know, 4 foot.
He
something.
Looks tall. Yeah, he's not like a foot and a half raccoon. He's definitely a 4 foot creature,
at least 4 feet.
But I would say that what's his name? Adam Gorham. Right? Mm-hmm. Adam Gorham, I like his take on all of the characters. The Technet characters. I think he really spent time on what they look like, different unique qualities about them. One thing that I really liked about the layout of this was that it wasn't just a grid. You know, like a...
Yeah, boring.
A boring grid. This actually was pretty easy to follow. I mean, I might have gotten lost on like two pages, two spreads, but for overall, for not being a grid, it was really easy to follow.
Yeah, I enjoyed it because you got to read the narration, then you got to read the story, or yeah. You can even have done it in the opposite fashion, and it would have been, you would have still gotten like the same thing out of it. Mm-hmm. So I really liked that. And I really liked that he filled the spaces with all different types of characters.
Yeah.
And not necessarily ones that are a part of the main story, but we do get to see all these aliens and different creatures, which I really enjoyed about the first Guardians of the Galaxy, the movie, and I'm glad that we got to see it here.
Yeah, I think that he did a really good job at world building. So yeah. Developing those characters, but not only that, but Otto's world. You got to see really nice detail into Otto's world, and that's a really important part of the plot.
Yeah, that was one of my favorite panels, was when they showed us her world. I actually took a picture of it off my phone because I'm going to try and like recreate it and watercolor it later.
Really?
Yeah.
We're going to have to show you that. But is there something I was missing about art? Is there? Yes. So I would love to know, maybe you guys know, or maybe Adam Gorham could tell me, but why does Rocket not have pupils? Right?
Yeah. And it's the covers just, he does.
Does he?
On this cover.
Oh, he does. But that's somebody else drew that.
Yeah. It's a different artist.
Andrew Mayhem, Mike Mayhem, something Mayhem. I know, drew that cover for number two. But in Adam Gorham's, I keep thinking Al Gorham, but Adam Gorham's version of Rocket, his eyes or eyeballs are just red. So I would love to know why. I would love to know why. Maybe it's foretelling something.
It could be part of his past, or maybe it was just a stylistic choice. Mm-hmm. That could just be a nuance, or mm-hmm. I thought it was cool.
I like that. Plot. So I touched that. Otto's like the main plot to this.
Yeah, the story arc.
To this story. Rocket can have a girlfriend.
Yeah, that's really cute.
Everybody needs to find love. So the story will take you through what's going on. That's how it begins and what's going on between that. Right? Or at least what he's doing now that she's back in his life. And why TechNet is helping him do something. I mean, that's all we'll say.
Yeah, but it's a fun ride, I think. At one point felt like a little predictable because I also think that he wrote it so you would predict it too. Anyway, I don't know.
It's written simply enough for teenagers. Like that's what I feel about the plot. It's definitely,
I feel like a lot of comics are geared towards that age group. Especially Marvel ones.
Marvel, okay. This is why I've never read a Marvel freaking comic.
Well, I mean, they come out with these character comics to piggyback off of the movie. Mm-hmm. And the movie was PG-13.
Yes.
So obviously they're not going to make a comic that's an R-rated comic or mature comic.
No, I get it. But let's get some plot twists. That's what I want. I want some plot twists.
That you can't predict.
That I can't predict. Because I personally feel like I read the first one. I really liked the first one. Then I read the second one and I was like, I think that this story is going to progressively get uninteresting. More and more uninteresting.
Gonna stick to it. I want to see how it works out, and I at least want to get to the point where he meets Peter Quill. At least that far, which I don't know how long they plan to take this one. They probably only plan on taking it as far as like a trade paperback.
That's true.
Yeah, these movie spin-off comics usually don't get a very long run, which is fine, but I don't know. If I wind up really liking it, then I'm going to be sad.
But Marvel canceled a previous Rocket. I think it was Rocket Raccoon that they canceled back in April. And then I don't even think they finished that storyline from what I've read online.
So they started it, they came out with it.
Yes. It was I'm not sure how many issues it had, but then they canceled that one and then they did this one in May. So this Rocket number one came out on May 10th, in case you're looking for it. But yeah, they canceled it back in April and then let's put out a twice monthly Rocket.
I wonder why they did that.
I don't know. We'll have to do some detective work.
I don't know, maybe the writer or the artist left for different projects or there was creative differences or something like that.
So then I think logistically, it must be really hard as a writer and artist to do a twice monthly comic that's going to continue to be interesting. So maybe that's why.
Especially having, I don't know if this would have any attachment to Disney because Marvel is owned by Disney or they have a stake in some of Marvel stuff. You guys can clarify that for me. You're really good at that.
We need a lot of help.
It's just, this world is so big now and there's so much to follow.
Yeah,
that
there's too much.
It's easy to get lost, especially in the politics of it. But that could be another, you know, stressor on the artist and the writer. Because I know a lot of movies are like that when Disney, well, not necessarily Disney, but when it's a superhero owned by a different entity and then you have another production company that comes in on it and then a director has a totally different vision. It's like a lot of different control given pull. Exactly.
You already lost me.
It's not a surprise to me if it did like get the plug pulled on it early or if they decided just to scrap it and start something new.
True. Gotta make money. I mean, at the end of the day, that's what they're thinking about.
Dollar bills.
Let's make money.
Anyway. I'm done talking about Rocket. So Lisa didn't like the second issue, and I kind of forgave the fact that it was a little predictable, a little bit like spoon feeding, because they give a nod, a really funny, clever nod to another character in the Marvel universe, Daredevil, because Rocket winds up having to be defended by a lawyer who is Froggy. His name is Froggy and he is a frog.
Oh, that's what you're talking about.
Yes. And then he's like, oh, don't worry, this will be great, amazing. And you know, my colleague's gonna come in. He's blind, but you know, as long as we got him on our side, you're good to go.
Yes.
And then he's like, as long as he doesn't get, you know, pulled away to some mysterious reason, and then I don't see him for a few days.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, that you lit like a light bulb in my head now. That makes sense. Can I read it now?
Yes, you can read it.
I'm going to rate Rocket number 1 and 2. A 3. No, I'm just kidding. A 6 out of 8 pizza slices. So
I would give it the same rating.
I'm going to give it a 6. A solid 6. Because I really enjoyed reading it. I just don't have a future. I don't think it has a future in my pull list.
Okay.
So you're rating it a 6 out of 8?
Yeah, I'd give it a 6 out of 8. Just because it's not exactly the most... Like, it's a lot of fun. I just can't think of the word that I want to use. It's a lot of fun.
Fun?
I'm just reiterating what I just said. Lisa, full repeating, not reiterating. Those are two different words. Obviously. It was a lot of fun. I like the colors. I love Guardians of the Galaxy, especially the last movie, and I can't wait for the next movie. And I just can't get enough of them.
Of this universe?
Yeah. Yeah. Not that I can get enough of Marvel. There are a few characters that I will always stick by. Like, I like GOTG, I love Thor, I used to really like Captain America, but that's about it for now. Mm-hmm. And Jessica Jones and Luke Cage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alright. That's it.
Okay.
Thank you so much for watching, Goldiebots. Please remember to hit the bell. Hit the bell.
Hit that bell. I think it's somewhere over here.
So that you do get notifications when we put up new videos. And don't forget to subscribe so that when you do hit the bell, then you get the notifications and then we come up in your email, possibly.
You get to see our faces.
Yeah.
And listen to us talk about things.
Things. Thanks so much and we'll see you next time.
Bye. Bye.